how you doing? Happy February. Okay, so tonight I'm very excited to be bringing to you what I'm calling the Battle of the Totes comparison video. I just so happen to have 5 totes all at once, and 3 of them are sold, and before I shipped them, I'm like, you know what, I'm just going to do a quick comparison video to kind of show you. Now I say quick, okay, this is probably going to end up being a 2-part video, just because I don't like for them to be over a certain length for uploading, and I don't have fancy equipment. So anyway, these are the 5 totes that I want to give you a quick comparison on tonight. Now, I will say that most of them I do have like its own individual review video, except for 2 of them, and I will have those posted on all of them later. There's 2 of them that I don't have, but I'll get those. But for tonight, I just wanted to show you this. Okay, so the first one is the Palermo GM, this big mama right here. Okay, the second one is the Bellevue GM in the Vernis print. This color is Amarante. Okay, the third one is the Wilshire GM. The fourth one is my beloved Raspail MM. And then bonus, remember how last week I did a review video on the All-In MM? Well, did y'all know that when they first launched out the All-In tote, it actually was available in a PM size too? Sure was. I got that for you too. That's an added bonus. I wasn't expecting this to come in today, and so I was super excited when I got it. So I'm just going to go over like just the measurements on all of them, and then just kind of do like a mod shot. And then I also have like my puffy coat back here because I wanted you to be able to see, you know, how it fits like when you have on a bulky coat. So, okay, I'm going to start with, I've got my list over here. I'm going to start with the Wilshire GM. Where's that? Okay. The Wilshire. Oh,
all these down.
Oh, dang it. Never mind. I can't. Okay. Wilshire. So the Wilshire is a discontinued bag, and it was available also. It came in 3 sizes, PM, MM, and GM. And again, this is the GM. And so the measurements are 17 inches at the bottom, and at the widest point, you know, she's usually like in the middle, it's 20 inches. And then at the top, she's 16 inches. And then she's 12 inches tall and like 6.5-ish inches deep. She has non-adjustable straps, and the strap drop is about 10 inches. Kind of, sort of, fits the, you know, passes the elbow test. Depends on if you kind of do a wonky. Depends on your body size. If you're a petite gal, you shouldn't have any trouble. If your arms are shorter, I have, like, orangutan arms, and so I have to do a bit of a wonky to get, you know, to get it on my shoulder. No big deal, though. And then, the interior of this bag is the dark brown Alcantara lining, which is like a microfiber, like luxurious interior. She does not have a zipper closure. She just has this clasp, like what you see in the Neverfull. And then on one wall over here, there is a huge, generous zip pocket that will fit a full-size wallet. I actually demoed in the video for it that I have posted. My zippy organizer fits in that wallet, I mean in that pocket, so no trouble there. There's a D-ring right here, as you can see. On the other wall, you've got 2 side-by-side pockets that are similar to the 2 pockets that are in the Artsy, or at least the old Artsy. I don't know about the new one, but make sure you can see that. Okay, and they're about the same size. So it's hard to say if they're gonna fit all cell phones because, you know, honestly, the cell phones are in all shapes and sizes now, and I don't know. It's not a traditional cell phone pocket, so it's not the tiny one. It is kind of the bigger one. But definitely there's some organization in this bag. And she does have feet. Okay, you can see she's got these cute leather, these nice leather accents on either side of the bottom. And then I do like the fact that she has this plate in the middle here. It's got the Louis Vuitton on it. It's just kind of a very basic, but just with a little something-something with the plate. Like, it's basic, but then you got a little something with the plate, the feet, the little, you know, leather accents on the side. And then also the shape. I really like the shape of the straps, like right here. You know how they're kind of pointed? Now, the straps are, as you can see, they're flat, but not completely flat, okay? Not as flat as, like, the Palermo flat. See how these are, like, really flat? Okay, so these, I don't know, it's almost like an extra added touch. They're just, you can kind of see it's raised on the top just a little bit. I don't know if you can tell that from the video. And I don't want to say, I mean, it feels like padding, and I'm going to say padding because that's what's coming to my head. But they're not padded like, you know, it's going to protect your shoulder. Although it is fairly comfortable on your shoulder. But anyway, that's kind of like, you know, the comparison, because you got the flat on the Palermo, which is also on the Cava series, okay? And then you have these, see there, it's kind of, maybe you can tell from that angle right there, it's kind of raised on the top here. And then they're a little bit thinner than the Palermo handles, okay? And then, okay, so that's all I'm gonna say on this one. I'll go back and point out some other things in just a minute. Okay, so the second bag that I wanna go over with you is the Palermo GM. The Palermo GM only came in a PM and a GM. And I actually do not have, even though the Palermo GM, or PM, was my first bag. It was, my sister gave it to me. It was pre-loved, she gave it to me. And I used that one. I don't actually have a video because I had the bag before I started doing videos and stuff. But anyway, it was just the two sizes. This is the Big Mama. And so she measures 13 and a half at the bottom, okay? Because it does have a structured base. Well, it's not super structured, but there is a little bit of a structured base right here. And then at the widest point, so right here, you know, like in the middle at her hips, she is 21 inches wide. And then at the top, she's 17 inches. So you've got plenty of room to get in and out of this bag, no trouble at all. She's 14 inches tall, so a little bit taller than the Wilshire. And then 7.5 inches-ish deep. I say ish because I only measured this piece, okay? But you can see that that's what sits on a flat surface, but it does go out. So you actually do have more room than that. Okay, now the straps are adjustable, 4 inches being the shortest length, and then 8 inches being the longest. And I think right now I have it on the longest. And so 8 inches is kind of, you know, I don't know, it's iffy. I mean, I know the Wilshire had 10 inches, and this one kind of feels like the same, but although, here, let me just see. So, okay, yeah, you can kind of see there, it's just a, it doesn't come across that well. I know they kind of look the same in the video, but I did measure it, and I double checked it, so it's 10 inches on that Wilshire, and this is 8 inches. Now, the bonus on the Palermo is that there's two D-rings on either side, and she comes, if you can find one with the strap, it has a shoulder strap, and it is also adjustable, and the strap will go anywhere from 13 to 17 inches. That's pretty much your range on this. And the hardware on the Palermo is kind of, it's really nice. It's like jewelry quality as far as how it looks. Because see, you've got like the rounded D-rings, which are really nice. They're kind of chunky. And then right here on the buckles, see, they're just kind of rounded. They're not that flat like you see on, well, right here. See how the D-ring, I mean, the hardware on this all-in are just flat. They're kind of just, you know, basic. And you get the same thing on the Cabos. I mean, I always say Cabos now. Cabas. On the Cabas series, it's the same thing. They're just kind of flat. And well, actually, these aren't technically flat. They're a little bit rounded, but you get the idea. These are just basic and square, okay? And then on this one, on Palermo, they're fancy, okay? So you got the fancy buckles here. You've got the fancy rivets. Rivets. See how they're kind of bubbly looking? And they're engraved with Louis Vuitton. They're really nice. And then no feet. No feet. And then what else? What else? Okay, so you've got the heat stamp here in the front. And then my favorite thing of this bag is the zipper pull. It's like a bracelet, like a Tiffany bracelet. You've got the little charm right here with the LV on it. Nice quality links, chunky. The zipper itself is chunky. And so, and it's a wider zipper. Okay, so again, well, zipper closure, because I forgot to mention that part. You can see that. Okay, the interior is that of a Speedy. Okay, huge room in here. Huge room, that doesn't even make sense. Huge space, okay? Now, and there is organization, because on this wall, you have a generous slip pocket over here, and I do say in my video, but I just have this right here. It will fit my Zippy organizer, okay? So, no problem there. On the other side, you have one slip pocket, and then you do have a little, the old model cell phone pocket right here, okay? And then you do have a D-ring on the side, okay? So you've got the basic brown, the traditional brown canvas interior, pockets over here, the two. This one's big. I wanna say that it would fit all cell phones, but again, I don't know, it just depends, you know, it depends on your case size and all that. So tons of room here. So again, you can carry it either by the handles, you can throw it over your shoulder with this strap, and you've got those options. I like these straps because they're nice and flat. They do sit nicely over your shoulder. Now, in my experience, because I've reviewed just about every type of strap, handles or straps, and I'm going to tell you that there's not really a perfect strap that fits on your shoulder. I mean, they're all going to kind of come off a little bit. And I guess it depends on, you know, your size. I mean, I feel like my shoulder is just kind of average. But like today, I was carrying the All In, which has these flat ones. And, you know, I mean, just kind of depending on how you're holding it, you are going to have the one that goes like that. I mean, that's just kind of like, I don't know. You know, I guess it's just something you're just going to have to just deal with. You know what I mean? Okay, so this one, you can also, I'm going to have to start using this stool. Okay, so on this one, see, this video is already 10 minutes, so I'm probably going to have to do 3 videos. You can access it from your shoulder with no trouble, okay? And so there you go. I'm going to keep moving. Okay, I thought I was going to at least get through the first round. All right, next one on my list is my beloved Raspail, okay? Raspail MM. Now, the Raspail was all, it's discontinued as well. Palermo's discontinued. I don't know if I mentioned that. But the Raspail came in the PM, MM, and GM. And I've never seen the GM in person, and I've never seen the PM in person, only the MM. And so she measures 15 inches at the bottom, 22 inches at the widest point, 20 inches at the top. She is 11 inches tall and 7 inches deep. So she big, okay? And then the non-adjustable strap, as you can see, is a little over 7 inches. So this is not a bag that's going to pass the OVO test. You're going to have to put it on your shoulder. And that's just, you know, I know, just that's just tough times, right? When you gotta actually put a bag on your shoulder. I'm kidding. Okay, you can access it from your shoulder, no problem. The interior of this bag is nice as well. Okay, so you've got that maroon colored canvas. It's uncoated. And so, well, here, I'm gonna go on this side. So you've got the one huge zipper pocket on this side, and it will fit a zippy organizer. And then it'll zip there, so that way, you know, because the bag actually does have a zipper closure, okay? I should have had it kind of, okay, so here's a zipper pull. It's one of those chunky zippers, but here's the thing. If I don't know if you can tell from the video, but you can see how the zipper closure does not actually go the entire length of the bag, okay? It's only a little bit. So when you have it zipped, you're gonna have these two ends open a little bit, okay? Can you see that? Like, if I pull this up, you can see that there is going to be a little bit of space there. See, from there to there, you're going to have that space. So, yes, it has a zipper closure, but honestly, if the bag falls over and you have something over on the side, it's going to come out. So anyway, just know that, but you do have that pocket. And I don't know if I mentioned on the other side, it has the two pockets, just like the Wilshire that I showed you, and they're, you know, and like the Artsy. And so they're going to fit most phones, I guess, or whatever. Okay, and then it has a D-ring. It's the D-ring over there in the corner, okay? And she does have rolled handles. And the size of the rolled handles are gonna be not as big as a Speedy bag, but not as small as the, I believe it's the Terrain. Those are pretty dainty, if I remember right. These are kind of a, you know, happy medium. They're in between, but they are nice. This bag, as you can see, is just super plain. This is all the Vachetta that you have on it, which is one of the reasons why I love it. There are no feet on it, and it's just all canvas. So it's kind of, sort of, a weatherproof bag. I mean, you know, I guess if you, okay, people are going to argue with me and go, no, it's not because it has leather. I mean, kind of, right? You know, just the handles. I mean, is that really that big of a deal if the handles get wet? I mean, you don't want them to get soaking wet, but you know what I'm saying. Okay, so again, Raspail MM. All right, next one is the Bellevue. This is a bag that I've been wanting to see in person for a long time. Now, okay, you know what? I'm already getting to almost 14 minutes, so I'm going to stop this video and continue in the next video. Okay?